'Twas not long before judges' night all through the court. The judges all worried they might come up short. Auditions were scheduled, the actors prepared. With Nicholas writing, we were all a bit scared. Us lawyers and paralegals slept in our beds while old lines from musicals danced in our heads. The season would end with a great New Year's Eve, but then we all wondered, what's up old Nick's sleeve? Then, as we all hoped, Nick might temper his humor. We heard people talking. We heard all the rumors. We worried and wished it would all soon be clear as we waited for Nicholas's script to appear. I'd read all the stories. I'd heard all the warnings as I sat in the Ark on that cold Thursday morning. There were donuts and bagels, a loud atmosphere, when what should I happen to then overhear? But a horrible wisecrack, one gross, crude, and sick. I knew in a moment it must be old Nick. Then one after the other, his jabs quickly came as he shouted and called out to the judges by name. Judge Wheaton, Judge Cresswell, Judges Gibson and Demling, Judge Else and Judge Wilson, Judges Wolf, Rome, and Sexton, at the top of his lungs, though each sounded the same. His jokes were at least funny, maybe at the top of his game. I listened intently. He ran through his work until once when I snickered, he turned with a jerk, and laying his finger in front of his lips, he gave a quick nod and said, I'll give you a tip. If you promise you won't say a word to your friends, I'll tell you today how this judge's night ends. You don't need to tell me, I then said with a grin, because it's always the same. The judges all win. Except for that one guy who everyone knows can run, but can't win place or show. Nick nodded and smiled and said, that's the routine. But this year could be different, if you know what I mean. And with that, he departed with a skip and a whistle, leaving me sitting there anxious and bristled. Still, I heard him exclaim, ere he walked out of sight, happy judges' night all, and to all a good night.